Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing an example about how to find the scalar equation of a plane. The example that we have gives us the normal vector n, 2, negative 9, 8, and the point on the plane, p, negative 1, 4, negative 2. So given those two pieces of information, the normal vector n and the point p, we can find the scalar equation of the plane. When you're finding the scalar equation of the plane, the formula that you're always going to be using is this a times x minus x0 plus b times y minus y0 plus c times z minus z0 equals 0. And in this formula, the normal vector n is represented by the points or the coefficients a, b, and c. So the normal vector n, these three coordinates here are a, b, and c, like our 2, negative 9, and 8. And x0, y0, and z0 are our three coordinates in the point P. So really at this point, it's just plug and play. We're going to go ahead and drop these coordinates from the normal vector and the coordinates from the point P into our equation, simplify, and solve. So let's go ahead and get started. Like I said, we're just going to plug in 2 for A, negative 9 for B, and 8 for C, and then we're going to plug in negative 1, 4, and negative 2 for x0, y0, and z0. We're going to leave x, y, and z completely alone, and those variables will remain in our equation. So when we plug in, we leave those numbers exactly as they are, and then to simplify, I'm just going to go ahead and remove double negatives like this, change this, you know, plus a negative just to a negative, etc. And then in the next step, we'll go ahead and distribute the coefficients on these here. You could leave the equation in this form, but we can simplify it further if we multiply out because we'll have these constants here, the positive 2, positive 36, and positive 16, that will combine into one constant. So once we do that, we have an x, y, and z term. We're going to arrange those in that order at the front of our equation with the constants at the end. So when all said and done, we end up with this as our final answer. It's going to be 2x minus 9y plus 8z plus 54 equals 0, and that is our scalar equation of the plane given this normal vector n and the point p. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!